Good morning, everyone. Can you hear me? And can you see the screen?
Yes, we can.
Okay, thank you for this invitation. Thank you to FAO for organizing this event. My name is Antonella Imborgia, and I've been working in the wine industry for 17 years now. I worked in different wine regions in Italy, Sicily, which is also my hometown. Tuscany, Veneto, Lombardia, actually some of the most vocated wine regions in Italy. And what I would like to share with you today is my observation of how wine and wine tourism are actually an important leverage of development in these areas. And this will be the topic of actually my presentation. So let's start from the basics, from a school definition. What is wine tourism? As we can read, wine tourism, it's about going to a specific place to enjoy a product, wine, but not just that, it's also about discovering a territory and discovering the community that lives in that territory. So it immediately comes to our attention that it's about sharing an experience with the value that comes with it. So this can be also applied not just for wine, but for many other agriculture products, as we can see later on. I think also that wine tourism is a sort of evolved form of rural tourism, in the sense that it comes at a later stage of a long developing process, and that is composed by certain stages. So I will try to give you some examples of these experiences that I had. So I think that farmers start to understand the potential that they have in a given agricultural product. And they take pride in that and they improve their skills. So the first step is like the identification of these potential. Then they start to market it. So they start to find unique selling points. And in wine, this is true, for example, in grape varieties or in production method or in the unicity of the soils. Identify some specific features that can add value to the offer, to the proposals. So here you start to need some specific professional competencies. Then you have to put this offer on the market. So you need also marketing experts. After doing that, you start to build a brand. So it's not just a generic product in a generic territory, but it's a specific name. So you name it, you label it, and you start to tell a story. And this is, for example, the case of the appellations, wine appellations. Italy is divided in different wine appellations, identifying specific areas. One example is Brunello, one of the most famous red wines in Italy and in the world. Amarone, again, one examples of very famous red wines. But it's not just wine, it's other agricultural products. In Italy, we have, for example, Parmigiano Reggiano, which is a product identifying a specific area and which is well known and an international bestseller. Or Prosciutto di Parma, or again, the apples of Trentino. So these are all examples of agricultural district that have capitalized on their agricultural product, creating wealth and helping the local economies. Last but not least, of course, communicating this, telling a story, which is not just a story of a product, but it's a story of a place, of a community, and this makes it unique, of course. So it's not just telling a product, but it's more just an entire territory, which is actually the point of all that. Because it's just like that you sell value and add value to the chain. So what are the implications, the positive effects of such a process when it starts to work? Of course, you create value for the territory. Let me give you again an example in wine. Montalcino, which is the village where Brunello is produced, back in the 70s was one of the poorest and most depressed economic area of Italy. Nowadays, after wine tourism is one of the most well-known, most prestigious. Million of people come every year, and it's a very wealth area. You create jobs and infrastructures, of course. You put small villages on the map. You put these small villages at the center of touristic routes. People come in these places, which become approachable, reachable. You create beauty because landscape change and it changes for the better. In wine regions, you have these beautiful hills covered by vineyards, which are cured like they were small gardens, actually. And beauty brings always positive effects. You make people stay, you make young people stay in their place of origins. They have a chance not to leave. They have a chance to stay in the territory and to have a perspective, to have livelihoods and to live in the place they were born. You stimulate collaboration between local entrepreneurs because, of course, these agricultural districts are systemic by definition. You are not there to sell a product or a brand or just a company. You cannot do that all alone. You sell an heritage, it's a shared heritage, and this implies, of course, collaboration, partnerships, and a system. And you preserve biodiversity, promoting sustainable development. And this is a very important issue, of course, because researchers say that ecotourists prefer green practices, prefer going in places where environment is protected. And this, of course, pushes companies to align to green protocols. And this is a very important positive effect, of course. So what happens when this system works? I can give you, again, the Italian examples. Italy is the world's largest producer of wine, and it has numbers of different appellations, wine appellations. So it is naturally conceived to exploit the potential of wine tourism. And these are some numbers. Wine tourism in Italy amounts for 3.5 billion euro and welcome every year 15 million visitors. These are people who come here and becoming brand ambassadors. They go back in their homes, in their countries, and they tell family and friends what they have experienced. So they export value, they export the made in Italy and invite people to come in the future. So what are the big takes home for other areas of the world? For sure, agricultural products, agricultural districts, if well managed, are a proven boost for rural economies. This really works. This brings wealthy, this brings perspective to people, to community. Of course, to do that, you need specific professional competencies. You need people to understand the product, to understand how to enhance it. You need marketing experts to put this offer onto the market and to build brand and value. And last but not least, the very important issue of environment. Agrotourism preserves biodiversity and bring people into the nature, becoming more sensitive and more aware of the environment. So my presentation finishes here. I thank you for your attention, and I hope to have given you a small practical insight of wine tourism. Thank you.